ओके प्लेटलेट टेस्ट, ओके सी प्लेटलेट टेस्ट इज यूज्ड टू फाइंड द बेयरिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ द शैलो फाउंडेशन आर सेटलमेंट ऑफ द फुटिंग. ओके इट इज यूजफुल. To find the bearing capacity, of shallow foundation practically, you know, theoretically by using Terzaghi formula or Meyerhoff formula you can find bearing capacity, but practically by conducting test, okay, you can find the bearing capacity more accurately, of course, okay, practically and more accurately. Also we can estimate settlements, of course immediate settlements. Okay, so basically platelet test should be conducted at a depth of foundation. So suppose if you want to if you want to put foundation at a 2 meters depth, so test should be conducted at a 2 meters level only. That means the test is like this. So suppose ground, this is ground level, and we need to excavate pit. So first we need to excavate pit like this. So what must be the pit size? Okay, that and all we will see. So depth of the pit must be equal to depth of the foundation. That means that the at whatever depth you want to find that bearing capacity of foundation, the depth of foundation we need to maintain that. Depth of foundation. Generally, we use 300 mm plate or sometimes 750 mm plate. Okay, plate in plate load test we use. So plate is generally square size, square shape. Okay, square shape of size ranging from 300 mm to 750 mm. Okay, that is plate size. So generally the pit size must be, the pit size must be 5 times of breadth of plate, where BP is the breadth of plate. That is BP, breadth of plate. So 5 BP by 5 BP generally. So other than that also you can provide, not a problem. Generally we provide like that, 5 times of BP each side, side square pit we excavate. So then we can keep the plate, generally the plate will be here at center. We provide a plate, that square plate like this. Okay, plate. Okay, so we apply pressure on the plate in the by means of reaction beam or cantilever. So that means with the hydraulic jack we give pressure slowly. Okay, of course that parallelly by increasing the load settlement will take place. The settlement will be measured actually. So this is the load, we keep on applying load. So this is the breadth of the plate. So load by area is the pressure, right? The dial gauge will be there to measure the settlement. With the help of dial gauges, settlement can be measured. Settlement can be measured for the applied load. As you increase the load, what happens generally? as you increase the load, settlement also increases, right? So as you increase the load, pressure will be increased. Load by area is the pressure, right? Pressure equal to what? Applied load by area. Area is nothing but BP into BP, right? BP into BP is the area. So load by area is the pressure. As pressure increases, settlement will increase. So finally, we need to draw a graph. Okay. Draw a graph between pressure versus settlement. Pressure versus settlement. Okay. That means the graph will be like this. Suppose this is pressure, this is settlement, immediate settlement, okay? Immediate settlement, okay? So if you draw this graph, it will be like this. For clay soil means, first it will be like this and then at collapse, it drops like this. That means without increasing any pressure, the much more settlement takes place. That is the indication of failure, right? So this is for stiff clay. Stiff clay, the graph may be like this. Okay. Similarly, for dense sand, the graph may be like this. For dense sand. Okay. So for loose sand and soft clay, the graph will be, okay. See, you will not identify the ultimate pressure like this. This is soft clay. And loose sand means it may be like this. That means for loose sand and soft clay, you cannot identify the ultimate pressure, okay, failure pressure. So for stiff clay and dense sand, we can find QU, that means failure load. Failure load easily. Okay, that means, see here, like this, this is the QU. So for this sand, this one is the QU for dense sand. This is the QU for stiff clay. Then for loose sand or soft clay, how to find failure load? So for loose sand and soft clay, so actually you can draw a log-log graph. Log-log graph you can draw. That means indirectly, that means this is log Q, this is log SI. That means log-log graph, okay? If you draw this log-log graph, what you will get is, so the break will be there in the slope, like this. The break will be there in the slope. The break indicates QU. Okay, this is for soft clay or loose sand.
Yes, sir.
Otherwise, one more way you can follow basically. Actually, here the loose sand, it will not be like this. That is, it may be like this, okay? For loose sand. That means for soft clay or loose sand, the graphs may be if you draw directly instead of log log scale, that will be like this. Q versus SI, if you draw, the graph may be like this. That means initially if you see a straight line, you can observe, and finally also on straight line you can observe, these straight lines may intersect here. So in this way also you can find QU. Okay, by drawing tangents, that means by drawing tangents to initial portion, final portion, then also you can find ultimate load. Okay, failure load or ultimate load. So these are the tangent at final portion. This one is the tangent at the initial portion. Okay, so after drawing, after conducting the test, what you are doing, just with the help of jack, hydraulic jack or some reaction beam, you are applying load gradually and you are parallelly you are observing the settlement. So for a given load, how the settlement is responding, how the settlement is increasing, that we are plotting here, and finally you are calculating ultimate load as well. Okay, so what is the use of these graphs? So what we are going to achieve finally, so that we are see here in this equations. So how to find ultimate bearing capacity of the proposed foundation? Ultimate bearing capacity of proposed foundation. Our footing, okay, that is the foundation size is BF into BF, breadth of footing into breadth of footing, square size. Okay, so how to find its bearing capacity? Okay, that is important here. Ultimate bearing capacity. See, suppose footing size may be 2 meter by 2 meter, 3 meter by 3 meter, but you cannot use that much size of plate, right? So because if you go for bigger size plate, obviously you need to apply much more load, which is not practical. Practically that much load you cannot put. That's why we are going for smaller size plates like 300 mm or 750 mm. Okay, that means to minimize the cost of the experiment, we are reducing the size. So size effect will be there actually. So based on this experimental results or this theories, empirical theories, so we can estimate ultimate bearing capacity of the proposed foundation. Basically, soil is clay soil. For clay soil, okay. So ultimate bearing capacity of foundation is equal to ultimate bearing capacity of plate itself. That means whatever bearing capacity you are getting, same will be there for clay soil, because you know the clay soil, actually that for clay soil bearing capacity does not depend on size, right? Because CNC plus Q1Q plus gamma B and gamma, the third term will be zero. Size effect will not be there for clay soil. So whatever plate bearing capacity is there, same will be there for footing itself, footing or foundation also, for clay soils. Clear?
Yes, sir.
But for sandy soils, you know, bearing capacity increases with the size actually. So size effect will be there. Obviously, here logic is the bearing capacity is proportional to size actually. That's why QU of foundation equal to QU of plate multiplied by breadth of footing by breadth of plate. This factor we need to multiply. Okay. Breadth of footing by breadth of plate. See, breadth of plate is around 300 mm. That means 0.3 meter. Breadth of footing may be 3 meters. That means 10 times it is increasing for sandy soil, right? Based on the sizes, it increases for sandy soil, bearing capacity increases. This is very important for gate, okay? Bearing capacity. Not only this, settlements also. So how to find settlement? Okay, based on the settlement of the plate, how can we determine settlement of the foundation? Okay, so settlement of the foundation for a given intensity of loading. Intensity of loading Q naught. Suppose on the plate Q naught intensity is there. So if footing also experiencing same intensity of loading, then what would be the settlement of the foundation? That is the question here. Okay, whatever plate having the intensity, same intensity we apply for footing also, then what would be the settlement of the foundation? That is the question here. So for clay soils, settlement of foundation equal to settlement of plate. See, one thing you should remember here, on plate as well as footing, intensity of loading is same. Intensity means what? Pressure, load by area, must be same. Settlement of footing equal to settlement of plate multiplied by breadth of foundation by breadth of plate. Understood, no? For clay soil, settlement is proportional to plate size. Proportional to the footing size. More the footing size, settlement will be more. Clear, Gada? For clay soils.
Yes, sir.
Similarly, yes. For sandy soils, we will not have any linear relationship actually, but some nonlinear relationship is there. They have established like this, SF equal to SP into BF by BP into BP plus 0.3 by BF plus 0.3 BP plus 0.3 by BF plus 0.3. Okay, whole square, where BP and BF must be in meters. So note here, intensity of load must be same on plate and footing, then only this relationship is valid. Okay, clear, Gada? These four things are very important for gate. Okay, it is very simple also, you can remember easily. Okay, now see the problems also in gate exam. Note on the problem. Gate 2017. Second paper. Okay. Question was like this. The plate load test was conducted on a clay strata. By using (0.3 m/0.3 m) dimensions and the ultimate load per unit area. That means what? That is intensity, right? Ultimate load per unit area for the plate was 180 kilopascals. Okay. The ultimate bearing capacity in kilopascals of a 2 meter wide square footing would be option A 27, option B 180, option C 1200, option D 2000. See, for clay soil, bearing capacity of plate and foundation must be same, irrespective of the size of the footing, right? Whatever may be the footing size, bearing capacity will be same, ultimate bearing capacity will be same. For the plate, it is 180. Obviously, for the footing also, it must be
180.
180. Yeah. Like this. Suppose same test if you conduct on sandy soil, suppose. Instead of clay strata, if it is sandy, okay, what to do? So for clay soil, QU of foundation equal to QE of plate, but for sandy soil means QU of foundation equal to QE of plate multiplied by BF by BP, right? That means if the soil is sandy soil, then it is QE of foundation will be plate. It is 180. Footing size is 2 meters. Plate size is 0.3, which is equal to
1200
kilopascal. Okay. If it is sandy soil, answer would be 1200. Okay. It would be 1200 if it is sandy soil. If it is clay soil, it is 180. Okay. Next, one more problem. A plate load test on sandy soil comma the test plate . 60 centimeter by 60 centimeter undergoes a settlement of at a pressure of 120 kilopascals. What will be the expected settlement of 3 meter by 3 meter footing under same pressure? So pressure is same. That means 120 kilopascal means what is the load on plate? 120 into 0.6 into 0.6, right? What is the load on footing? 120 into 3 into 3.
3 into 3, yes, sir.
Yeah, load will be different, but still pressure is same. So yes, we need to find settlement. Okay, it's very simple. Settlement of foundation equal to settlement of plate, because it is sand. So BF by BP into BP plus 0.3 by BF plus 0.3 whole square. Okay, which is equal to settlement of plate is 5 mm multiplied by BF 3 BP 0.6 and BP 0.6 plus 0.3 by BF is 3 plus 0.3 whole square, which is equal to how much? 9.29 mm? Okay.
Yes, sir. 9.29, sir.
At 9.29 or 9.3. Okay.
Okay, sir.
9.3 mm. Suppose instead of this one, sandy soil, instead of sandy soil, suppose clay soil is there. Okay. So then SF would be how much? SF equal to SP into what? Simply BF by BP, right? Which is equal to 5 into BF is 3, BP is 0.6, which is equal to how much?
25 mm.
Okay. So like that, you should be very careful whether it is sand or clay. For bearing capacity or settlement, you can work out easily. So basically, practically, based on the allowable settlement, see, in if you see 1904 code, IS 1904 given actually in this code given for different buildings, what is the allowable settlement clearly given. So if you know the allowable settlement, so from these graphs actually, if you know the settlement, okay, for a given settlement, you can find the allowable pressure also, right? For any curve. Understood, no? If you have these curves readily available with you. Okay. Suppose Q versus settlement, you have readily this graph. Suppose this is the graph. Okay. So safe set, I mean allowable settlement. Allowable settlements for a given footing, I mean given type of building, for a given type of building and footing, of course, can be read. Okay, you can read that allowable settlement. Sometimes it may be 40 mm, sometimes it may be 50 mm, sometimes it may be 60 mm. Okay. For a given allowable settlement, what would be the allowable pressure? Okay. Sometimes you may not go for, you may not use this ultimate bearing capacity theory. Okay. Settlement may decide the design. So bearing capacity also must be within the limit, as well as settlement also must be within the limit, right? Allowable pressure. Allowable settlement, right? Sometimes, for a given settlement, allowable pressure may be lesser than the, say, bearing capacity. Then what you will use? Obviously, based on settlement, whatever pressure is there, the lesser pressure than SBC, that must be used in the design. Clear, Gada?
Yes, sir.
So you should thorough about this 1904 code also for the practical purposes, not for gate point of view. Gate point of view, you need only two things. This one, so, settlement, ultimate bearing capacity for foundation, how to find, and the settlement of foundation, how to find. These four formulas you need to remember. And of course, these curves also you should remember, okay? For stiff clay or dense sand, clear cut ultimate bearing capacity directly can work out, but for loose sand or soft clay, the change of curvature or whatever that, in log graph, you can see the abrupt change. That is the ultimate capacity, ultimate bearing pressure. Or otherwise, starting and ending, if you draw a tangents, wherever that tangent intersect, that gives you the, ultimate bearing capacity of this plate. Okay. So that is here we are working out only plate bearing capacity. Footing bearing capacity, again, we need to work out based on these formulas, bearing capacity of this clay and sand will be like this. Any doubt?